How to use a stainless steel pan without any sticking. Stainless steel pans aren't just for professional cooks. They deserve a spot in your cabinet too. Nonstick pans can only tolerate moderate heat and have limited lifespans. But a stainless steel skillet is virtually indestructible and can get hot enough to give your food a proper sear. The secret lies in how they're constructed. A 5-ply pan has 5 layers of metal that are sandwiched together. Our pan's layers alternate between stainless steel and aluminum. Aluminum heats up quickly, and steel holds onto that heat. The result is a durable pan with great heat retention, which makes for awesome browning. So, how do you cook with it without getting your food stuck? The answer lies in preheating. By allowing your pan to get hot enough before adding food, you can enjoy the benefits of stainless steel with no mess and no worries. There are a few ways to judge whether your pan is hot enough. The water bead test is an easy and visual way for beginners to get the hang of proper preheating. Stovetops are all different, but the water bead doesn't lie. You'll need a little bit of water, a spoon, your cooking oil, and your food handy nearby. First, heat your pan over a burner set to medium. After a minute or so, spoon a few drops of water into your pan and observe how it reacts. If it does nothing or sputters slowly, it needs to heat up some more. If it sizzles into many small droplets, it needs just a little more time. When the water forms a single bead that glides around the surface, now it's ready. Wipe the water away with a towel, add your oil, and tilt your pan to coat it. Then add your food. At a microscopic level, your oil and food will glide along your pan's surface, just like the water did. Every stovetop and burner is unique. Thankfully, this method allows you to tell your pan's actual heat without relying on guesswork. In the future, you can estimate your pan's temperature without water by holding your hand 1 to 2 inches above the surface and judging by feel. When it's uncomfortable to keep your hand there for more than 5 or 6 seconds, it's hot enough. You can also add your oil and judge by how the oil shimmers on the pan's surface. When the oil's surface begins to look wavy and the oil flows more quickly, your pan is ready. Beware of overheating. If your water splits into many small gliding beads, it may be too hot. Lower the heat and remove the pan from the burner for a few moments. Be ready with your food once you've added your cooking oil. Don't heat your oil for too long on its own, or you may burn it. In the event of a small fire, calmly turn off all burners, remove the pan from heat, and cover the pan with a lid to extinguish the flames. To learn more about our stainless steel skillets, check out Misen.com at the link below. Happy searing!